So wait to Omnes. Today we're looking at the story Historia Romana, the story about Aeneas. Sentences 27 to the end. All right. Constant historiam Romanum haberi initium ab Aenea et urbe Traiano. It's agreed that Roman history has its beginning from Aeneas and the city of Troy. Circum annum millesimum ducentesimum annum nota bene ACN signify ante Christum natum. So around the year 1200 of the common era, before the common era, nota bene ACN signifies before the birth of Christ. Graeci urbem Traiana oppugnabat. The Greeks attacked the city of Troy. Quod Paris filius regis Traiani, Helenam uxorem regis Spartani rapuit. The Greeks attacked the city of Troy because Paris, the son of the Trojan king, stole Helen, the wife of the Spartan king. Et Graeci voluerunt recipere Helenam et refere eam Spartam. And the Greeks wished to recover Helen and bring her back to Sparta. Graeci plurimos milites et plurimis navibus. Scisne quote naves Graeci habuerunt contra illam urbem duxerunt et ibi decum annos pugnabant ut poetae scripserunt. The Greeks led duxerunt led very many soldiers in very many ships. Do you know how many ships the Greeks had? Against that city, and there for 10 years fought as the poets write. So watch out. Ut plus the indicative there means as. Homerus scripsit de maximis factis quae Traiani accidescent. Homer wrote about the greatest deeds which happened at Troy. Tandem Troia capta et delata. So this is a nice little ablative absolute there. Capta et delata are PPPs, perfect passive participles describing Troy. So finally with Troy, having been captured and destroyed, Traianus Aeneas filius veneris cum sociis inviginti navibus profectus est et multos annos erebat ut novas terras inveneret ubi nova sedes et nova patria Traianis essent. So the Trojan Aeneas, the son of Venus, with his allies in 20 ships set out and wandered for many years in order to find new lands where the new seats and a new fatherland might be for the Trojans. Dei et fata Aeneam et socios duxerunt et auxilium eis dederunt ut poetae scripserunt. The gods and the fates led Aeneas and his allies and gave them help, as the poets write. Constat primo Traianus in Macedoniam isse, sed homines in Macedonia habitantes locum Traianus non daturus esse. It's agreed that first the Trojans had gone to it was agreed that the Trojans first went to Macedonia, but the people who were living in Macedonia, that's a nice habitantes, a nice PAP, so literally it's the people living in Macedonia, non daturos esse. That's a future infinitive, but indirect statement, so would not give a place to the Trojans. Ergo Macedonia relicta, therefore with Macedonia having been left, Aeneam et Traianus ad Cretam insulam navigavisse. Aeneas and the Trojans sailed to the island of Crete. Iterum in ille insula fuisse nullum locum, nullum sedem, nullum domum Traianis. Again, on that island, there was no place, no home, no domicile for the Trojans. Sedem and domum are synonyms for home. Igitur creta relicta, so again, a nice little ablative absolute. We have a relicta as a PPP of a relinquo. Again, with Crete having been left, ad isse ad Scyllium, they approached to Sicily. Sicilia relicta, another ablative absolute. With Sicily having been left, they went to the lands in the middle of Italy, nomine Latinum, named Latinum. Italia rat antiqua terra et constat multos annos ab hinc Titanum Saturnum ibi regnare. Italy was an ancient land. There's too many N's. Take out the second N. Was an ancient land, and it's agreed that for many years ago, the Titan Saturn ruled there. In media Italia erat Latinum, agri, campi, silvi, multi colles et flumen nomine Tiber erat in Latio. In the middle of Latium, in the middle of Italy was Latium, fields and open spaces, forests and many hills, and a river named Tiber were in Latium. Terrae circum flumen Tiberum appellatae sunt Laurentius Ager, et ibi rex Latinus aborigines sunt homines qui prima in Italia habitabant, virtute et pietate regit. The lands around the river Tiber were called the Laurentian Ager, or the Laurentian Field, and there King Latinus ruled the aborigines, the natives, with virtute et pietate, with virtue and pietas. Aborigines sunt homines, the aborigines or the natives are people who first lived in Italy. Cum Traiani ad litora Italia et Latinum vinescent, Aeneas et Traiani profecti sunt ex navibus et dulcem aquam et cubum et domum invenerit. When the Trojans had come to the fields of Italy and Latinum, Aeneas and the Trojans set out from their ships in order to find, in invenerent, is an ut clause purpose, to find sweet water and food and a home. Latinus et aborigines ex agris ex sua urbe concurrent et quid accidit. Latinus and the natives left from their fields and from their city, and what happened? Duplex est famina. There's twofold is the rumor, or twice is the story. Duae fabulae sunt, there's two stories. Quae fabula est vera, which story is true? In prima fabula erat magnum proelium. In the first story, there was a big battle. Rex Latinus et aborigines patrium defendere temptantes sunt victi, ab aeneam et Traianis. King Latinus and the natives, temptantes, nice PAP, trying to defend the fatherland, were conquered by Aeneas and the Trojans. Rex Latinus pacem petivit, et filium aeneam in matrimonium dedit. King Latinus sought peace and gave his daughter to Aeneas in marriage. In ultra fabula constant ante proelium rege Latinum convo cavisse aeneam ad loquium. In the other story, this is the second story, it is agreed before the battle, King Latinus called together Aeneas to a talk. Aenean et regem Latinum stedisse inter duos exercitus, exercitus est magnum manus militum. Aeneas and King Latinus stood between the two armies. An exercitus is a big group of soldiers. Ad colloquium regem Latini Aeneam rogavisse. At the talk, King Latinus asked Aeneas, O advene, qui estis? Unde venistis? Cur ad estis? Qui casus vos ad Latinum egerunt? O stranger, who are you? From where do you come? Why are you here? What misfortunes drove you to Latium? Aeneas responded, O Rex Latine, ego sum Aeneas filius veneris. O Aeneas responded, O King Latinus, I am Aeneas, son of Venus. Magni casus nos ad litera Italiae et tuam terram egerunt. Great misfortunes drove us to the shores of Italy and your land. Troia ab Graecis capta delata, nos perfecti sumus ut novam patrium inveniamus, ubi sedes Traiani sit. With Troy having been captured and destroyed by the Greeks. Now, capta delata, that whole phrase, Troia delata, is an ablative absolute. Nos perfecti sumus. We set out, ut, in order to find a new fatherland where there might be a home for the Trojans. In itinere nostra, i.e. id est, cum Traiani ab Troia ad Italiam navigabunt, cum Dei nos invenuit et fata ducunt, quaesimus domum in Macedonia, in Creta, et in aliis locis, sed nullus locus, nullus sedes, nullus domus ubique erant nobis. On the journey, when the Trojans were sailing from Troy to Italy, since the gods were helping us and the fates were leading, or while the gods were leading us, you can say while here as well, We sought a home in Macedonia, in Crete, and in other places. But there was no place, no home, no place of residence anywhere for us. Tandem video dicta factorum esse vera. Finally, I see that the words of the fates are true. Fata illa praedicunt, nos ad antiquum Latinum ubi Saturnus Titanus olim rexeret, venturus esse, et ibi urbem clarum conditurus esse. The fates predicted that we, and then you have to go to venturus esse, would come to the ancient Latinum where the Titan Saturn once ruled, and ibi, and there conditurus esse, the future infinitus, would found the famous city. Ex ille urbe homines fortes venturos esse et in futuro illos claros homines maximum imperium in mundo habituros esse. And from that city, brave men would come, and in the future, those famous men would have the greatest power in the world, or the greatest empire in the world. Rex Latinus nobilitatum Trojanorum et Aeneam pietatum admiratus est. King Latinus admired the nobility of the Trojans and the pietas of Aeneas. Casus fuerunt magni, sed Trojani magnos animos et virtutum habebat. The misfortunes had been great, but the Trojans had great courage and virtus. Viri ille sunt parati aut paci aut bello. Those men were prepared either for peace or for war. Rex Latinus pacem quae sivit et filium nominate Lavinia Aeneae in matrimonium dedit. King Latinus sought peace and gave his daughter named Lavinia to Aeneas in marriage. Aborigines Latini et Trojanus unus populus factus est et postea Aeneas host omnes in bello contra ducum turnum et alius Italius qui nolunt Trojanus neque in Latio neque in Italia habitare tuxit. So the Latin natives and the Trojans became one people, or were made one people. And afterwards, Aeneas, and then where we have the verb. Oh, we have to go all the way to the end. Tuxit. Led hos omnes, all these people in war against the leader Turnus and other Italians who did not want the Trojans, neither to live in Latium nor in Italy. So neque is neither or. Latini et Trojani were victorious at Oppidum Condit. The Latins and Trojans were victorious and established the city. Aeneas ab nomine uxoris Lavinium appellat. Aeneas calls the city Lavinium from the name of his wife. 60. Urbe condita post tres annos Aeneas mortuus est et situs est ad flumum numicum. Homines Aeneam jovem indignantem appellant. Nota bene Jupiter indignes est nomen dei qui in antiquo Latio invenitur. With the city having been established post tres annos, after 3 years, Aeneas died, and he was buried at the river Numicum. People called Aeneas the local Jupiter. Nota bene, Jupiter indignes is the name of a god who is found in ancient Latinum. And there we go. Valete omnes lingua Latina est vita.